Hi everyone, Mr. H here. So good to see you guys today. Today we're going to be learning about musical form with sea shanties. You've probably been hearing a lot of these songs going around. I guess they've been going around TikTok a lot or many other places, and they're really fun to listen to. So we're going to be learning a little bit about sea shanties and about form. And we're also going to see a lot of pictures of ships with a lot of sails and a lot of people singing on ships. So let's dive in. No pun intended. So first off, what even is a sea shanty? You probably heard it before and thought, well, what makes a song a sea shanty? Well, it's gonna be hard to say, by the way. Say sea shanty really fast. Sea shanty. It's a tongue twister. It's a lot of fun. Anyway, a sea shanty is a special type of song called a work song. These songs were sung while people were, well, doing work. Sea shanties were specifically sung by sailors at sea, kind of like that picture down there. It looks like they're kind of tugging a rope, doing something like that, maybe raising a sail. And they used the songs to help them do their work. Usually the songs had a rhythm or a pulse or something that would help them do what they were doing all at the same time. So kind of a fun way of keeping things moving. Many sea shanties were made up on the spot or improvised and had one person singing a line of the song while the rest of the crew would sing back. This is called call and response. So maybe looking at that picture, maybe the one person on the very far side who's pulling the rope down would sing something, and then everybody else pulling on the rope the other way would sing something else back. That's call and response. Today, many people think of sea shanties as folk songs. So a folk song is pretty much a type of music that people sing. They're usually older songs that come from different places and different cultures, and they usually tell stories or they're songs about people, but there's something that if someone started singing them, everybody would know what it was because they probably grew up with it or they heard it somewhere. So they're folk songs. Sea shanties would be the same way. Usually a lot of sailors would know different sea shanties because they've been out at sea a lot, or they went around to different boats or ships or whatever and heard a bunch of different sea shanties. Maybe they made up their own. So what kind of form does a sea shanty have? Oop, too far. I'm sorry. There we go. We're back. Whew. Since sea shanties could be about anything the singer wanted, they could also be in any form they wanted. Usually these songs were simple, so most of these could be in form like A, B, and A, or just A and B. Remember, when we talk about form, we use letters to decide which sections there always is, and we always start with an A form. Sometimes we'd go on to a B or a C or anything else we have, but because sea shanties were really simple, they were usually just maybe A, B, or A, B, A. So maybe different forms like that. And because they're call and response, usually they would change words in some spots and they'd bounce back and forth, but that'll all be one section. So we're gonna actually look at one of my favorite sea shanties right now. It's been going around. I've been hearing it a lot more, but I found a really nice recording of it, and it's called Leave Her Johnny. So really quick, we're just gonna say the words. We'll have other people sing them in a second, and this is just the first part. So we'll go one line at a time. I'll sing a line, then you sing a line. Are you ready? Here we go. I thought I heard the old man say, leave her, Johnny, leave her. It's a long, hard pull to your next payday. And it's time for us to leave her. Leave her, Johnny, leave her. Oh, leave her, Johnny, leave her. Oh, the voyage is done and the winds don't blow. And it's time for us to leave her. So if you look at the words, you see how some of the words, they're in regular typing and some of them are kind of that italicized, they're kind of slanted over typing. Well, in this song, this is kind of a call and response song. When it's regular words, that's the first person singing. And when it's the slanted type, it's everyone singing. So usually the one person would sing, I thought I heard the old man say, then everyone would sing, leave her, Johnny, leave her. Then one person would sing, It's a long, hard pull to your next payday, then everyone would sing, and it's time for us to leave her. And the entire next section, everybody sings, leave her, Johnny, leave her. Oh, leave her, Johnny, leave her. Oh, the voyage is done and the winds don't blow, and it's time for us to leave her. Now, there's a lot more words to this, but I just wanted to give you the first part, just to give you an idea of how it's going to work. We'll actually hear the rest of the song a little later. Now, this, I actually did some research because I was like, all right, well, who's Johnny and who's her? So I looked it up. So this song was usually sung towards the end of a voyage or when a ship was making port. So their job's done and they're bringing the ship back in. The sailors would sing the song as a reminder that their time on the ship was coming to an end and that they would be leaving her soon. The her in the song is the ship. See, back then, and really still today, everybody refers to ships as girls. They call them her. It's just something they've always done. Sometimes the sailors would make up words about what happened on the voyage, both good and bad. So a lot of words for this song change as you hear it, but they always have that leave her, Johnny, leave her part at the end. So it's usually switches back and forth. So maybe one person sings the beginning part, then everybody sings leave her, Johnny, leave her, and then the next person sings something else. And it just kind of goes on while everybody talks about what happened during the voyage. Now, if you look this song up yourself, you're going to find a ton of versions that have a lot of different words in it. I found a version that I particularly like, so we're going to listen to it. Now, while we're doing it, I want you to think not of the words, but where's the form? I'm going to give you a hint. We're only going to be using A and B here. So let's see if we can figure it out. Here's the video. Now, this is done by a group called the High Kings. They are a Irish singing group, I believe, and they do a really good job of this song and a lot of other sea shanties that kind of became folk songs. So let's listen.
Oh, I thought I heard the old man say, leave her, Johnny, leave her. It's a long, hard pull to the next payday, and it's time for us to leave her.
Here's a different one.
Leave her, Johnny, leave her. Oh, leave her, Johnny, leave her. Oh, the voyage is done and the winds don't blow. And it's time for us to leave her.
Keep going, let's listen.
Oh, the skipper was bad, but the mate was worse.
Everyone.
Leave her, Johnny, leave her. He'd blow you down with a spike and a curse. And it's time for us to leave her.
Everybody.
Leave her, Johnny, leave her. Oh, leave her, Johnny, leave her. For the voyage is done and the winds don't blow. And it's time for us to leave her. Oh, pull ye lovers, or you'll get no pay.
Everybody.
Leave her, Johnny, leave her. Oh, pull ye lovers, and then be laid. And it's time for us to leave her. Leave her, Johnny, leave her. Oh, leave her, Johnny, leave her. Oh, the voyage is done and the winds don't blow. And it's time for us to leave her.
Let's listen.
Oh, I thought I heard the old man say, leave her, Johnny, leave her. It's a long, hard pull till the next payday. And it's time for us to leave her. Leave her, Johnny, leave her. Oh, leave her, Johnny, leave her. For the voyage is done and the winds don't blow. And it's time for us to leave her. Leave her, Johnny, leave her. Oh, leave her, Johnny, leave her. For the voyage is done and the winds don't blow. And it's time for us to leave her.
And that's the end of the song. All right. So what form do you think that was? We all know it starts with A. Everything's got to start with A. I want to make the argument that it was A, B form, or what we call binary form, because there's only two parts, A and B. So the A part was the part at the very beginning. Oh, I thought I heard the old man say, leave her, Johnny, leave her. That whole part is A. But then when it came to, leave her, Johnny, leave her, oh, leave her, Johnny, leave her. That entire part, we can think of that as B. And they kind of switch back and forth. Remember, yeah, the words can change, but as long as the music stays the same, then it's always the same part. So I like to think of it as A, then B, then A, then B, then A, then B. And then when they sing the B part again at the very end, maybe that's like a coda. That's the very end of the song. Either way, I like listening to the song. It's very relaxing to me. It sounds like, yeah, we did come to the end of a long voyage. Just like this is probably the end of us talking about form. Or maybe we might do a little bit more later. We'll see. But for now, this is all the time we have. I hope you enjoyed singing some sea shanties. If you want to go out and find some more, please do so. Maybe you'll be able to figure out their forms or just enjoy hearing some of their songs. They're kind of fun. Till then, have a good day.